Hey, what's up, Zach? I believe you contacted me to try and figure out how to use these flying commas. Well, they're exactly like commas. They've got the same structure, same curve and blade, depending on which style you get. But the only difference is, as you can tell, that it's got a rope attached to it with a little safety rope on the end for your thumb to go through. Now the way you put this on, in case you don't already know, is that you flip your thumb over on the knot where you can grip it, take the safety rope, put it over the thumb, like so. Try to make sure that the blade is pointing towards you so you can perform the proper twirls. Now, how you perform the twirls is that you end up throwing it over and twisting the rope around your hands, like this. Okay? So this position you want to be holding it in, so you can perform the twirls and still, you know, have it in a safety wrap. Okay? Now the twirls end up just going in a really simple fashion, down, twisting around over the hand like this. And then you just twist it right back. Okay? Here it is, one more time. A little slower. And from another angle. Alright, a lot of times you'll be messing up where the rope will twist up, and instead of landing right back here, it'll land facing this way. That's alright, you know, it just takes a little practice and eventually you'll get it. Just keep doing it. Once you get the hang of it, do it a little faster. Alright, over on this thing, same idea. Just put the, once again, thumb right by the knot, swing the safety rope right over, and swing it over. This way, now you'll have to try something even harder. Try practicing with both of us at the same time. There's three different twirls you can try. You can try twisting it on your side, in front of you, or above you. Alright? Now, as for strikes, I don't know too many in particular. My instructor, my Taekwondo instructor, only taught me a few. You would be just striking forward, slashing across by putting it under your armpit, one of them as a guard and the other over your shoulder, kind of like the scrimmage stick, where you'll be slashing across and cutting down. Try that. Alright, now again, I can't say I'm very good at these at all, but I do know a few tricks that you can do with them. Now, after you practice going on the side, you can also do them at the same time. Maybe one down and one above. One over and one above on the other side. And you want to get a little more dangerous. And after you make sure you understood how this works very well, get used to it pretty well, you can try about three different spins over a limb. Okay? One of them that I find is pretty easy was you're going to have to get into like a horse stand position like this. So that way you have enough room between your groin and your knee. For this to pass through, what you're going to need to do is just you're going to need to swing it down and over, and instead of letting it wrap around your wrist, you're going to let it go under your leg, okay? Now try to make sure your wrist or your thumb touches the inside of your leg, so that way it has enough room to wrap around your leg. So here we go. Alright, you should see the blade peek out from behind my leg. So on the side view is like this. Okay, you can even double it up and try it on both sides. Okay, see, happen again. You'll expect this to happen after a while and you can figure out, you know, once you get better at it, you don't have to. Alright, another twirl is around the waist. This one is a little harder. It's kind of like nunchucks, okay? It's very similar. You're going to have to twirl it around instead of wrapping around your hand. You're going to touch the thumb to your waist. That way have enough room to swing around and poke out the side over here. Okay, there it is. Okay, other side. Okay. Can't really tell you a prerequisite twirl for that because it's more like the one in front of you. And instead of keeping it vertical like that, you want to keep it horizontal. Okay. All I can say about that, and the last one, which I find to be the hardest one because it's the most scariest, because you're about to hit yourself when you do it, thinking you might cut yourself even if they're not sharpened, is the neck twirl. Now this one is the same idea, just as easy as the hip twist, you just gotta be a little careful, okay? And don't do it unless you're ready to commit to it, or else you'll end up hitting the back of your head or swinging it around and maybe splitting your throat. Nah, that hasn't happened to me yet, but just be careful. You're just gonna have to twirl it around like you did with the weights, and this time, touch the thumb to the side of your neck. This will give it enough room to swing it around and poke around the edge of your, the side of your neck over here, okay? The handle should stop it, so it's not gonna, the blade isn't actually gonna touch your neck, it'll just look like it does. And to prevent it from hitting your elbow, you're just gonna have to keep your elbow down, that's all. Okay, so here it is. Again, sometimes the blade will end up pointing the other way, just comes with more practice. There we go. Just like that. This side. Alright, a little close up just so you can see how it looks. And that, my friend, are the twirls for flying kamas. There's one more that I just learned pretty recently. This was a little difficult. You gotta keep them hanging so you can have them wrapped around your hands for first, just so you can get used to it. And maybe you might want to try with just one, just so you can know how it works. Alright, so I got my thumb through the rope, safety around my thumb, and now all I'm going to do is just, you might want to pinch it with your hand, sort of like this, okay, like pinch with your thumb and your hands to keep the rope there, and then you're going to have to twirl it in and out, in and out, in and out, like figure eight, okay? Once you've got that figure eight done, try to see how it looks, side angle, yeah, the camera might help. Evaluate yourself for maybe me. Okay. It'll look cooler if you can match it with the other comma. Okay, make sure all the blade points are pointing inward. Okay. And figure eight one. Follow it with the other. Okay. Doesn't look as cool from this angle. This is just so you can see how it looks on this side. Okay? Now, the side, same idea. It's a hard concept to explain, but once you practice enough times, you know that you have to figure eight both of them and follow one or the other, then you kind of will pick it up and it will kind of look like this. Ah! Went the other way. That's okay. Alright, so, that's my tutorial, and this is Coach's tutorial on how to use flying kamas. See ya. Twirl, this one will go over the shoulder. After you've had it go over your hand, you can, or under your leg, you can swing it back up and it will go roll over your shoulder and end up poking the blade this way. Like that. Okay? So, a little faster would be like this. Come up with your own combination, mix and match, whatever you can. You don't always have to use twirl, it's just off. In fact, you can switch from one limb to the limb fin to another. I don't really know the real names of those, I'll just call them limb fin. And this way you can keep the combination flowing and a little interesting and fast. Up to you really. I'd like to see what you can come up with. Yeah, got it.